Yes. Very good morning, everyone. In the last few classes, I've been discussing about noise in various modulation schemes, be it AM, DSPSC, and FM. And in the previous class, I had discussed about FM threshold reduction mechanism, wherein the received signal strength drops below certain threshold, causing the FM receiver to perform unreliably. Thus, to overcome that problem, what we do is we use a mixer and a voltage controlled oscillator, right, to compensate for the loss of the frequency components at the input. We will use voltage controlled oscillator to infuse appropriate frequencies to the mixer so that at the input of the bandpass filter, the carrier signal to noise ratio can be threshold limit required, so that our FM receiver can reliably demodulate the message signal. Okay, so that's about FM reduction, threshold reduction block diagram. Now, moving on to another very important concept. This is very important with respect to your test as well as exam, pre-emphasis and de-emphasis circuit in AM, right? Now, to understand pre-emphasis and de-emphasis and circuits and the need for these circuits, let me consider a scenario. Assume that this is your transmitter and you have transmitted your signal either by using wired or wireless means, and this is your receiver, right? Now, all of you please pay attention and listen carefully. Here, if I look at my message signal, and draw the power spectral density of my message signal, will be having positive, negative frequency components and positive frequency component and zero frequency component. And ideally, it should be constant between these two limits, minus W2 plus W. This is the power spectral density of your message signal, right? So when I'm transmitting here between minus W2 plus W, it will be constant, it will be fixed, right? And now I will transmit this over long distance, right? I'll transmit this over long distance. Now, because of the complex communication channel, what are the other components that get added up? What are the other unwanted things that will get added up? What are the other components that will be added up in this communication channel along with the signal? For example, if my transmitted signal is S of T, here by the time S of T reaches the input of the receiver, it would have become X of T. X of T is nothing but S of T plus what else? Please answer in the chat box. It is the noise, isn't it? Noises will get combined or mixed or added up with your desired signal, and this is going to be your received signal at the input of the receiver. Okay. Now, all of you please listen carefully. Now, if I just focus on the power spectral density of the message signal at the input of the receiver, here something interesting happens. Here at the input of the receiver, this is the power spectral density of message signal at the transmitter. Now, let us see what will happen at the input of the receiver. So this is the power spectral density at the transmitter. Now when this reaches the receiver, if this is the receiver, as you all know, the receiver will have the message signal as well as noise signal will get added up. And if I draw the power spectral density of M of T at the input of the receiver, it will look like this. This is minus W, this is W, this is zero, and the distribution will be like this, right? So if you pay attention here, please listen carefully. If you pay attention here, my power spectral density at frequencies minus W and plus W have decreased, isn't it? The power in these frequency points have decreased greatly, right? And if I look at the other component power spectral density, that is the power spectral density of N of T, here the distribution will be reverse. Distribution will be reverse. That means here the noise will be more, and at zero noise will be less. So like this, see. Ideally, I should have got at the input of the receiver, that is PSD of M of D should be like a rectangle, minus W, zero, and W, right? And this is how my power spectral density should look like ideally, right? This is what I discussed here in the previous slide also, power spectral density of the message signal at the transmitter end and at the receiver end. Ideally, this is what I am expecting, okay? But this is what I have got. Why did I get this? Because the noise has taken over the power in this frequency band, in this frequency points, minus W. At minus W you have maximum noise, and at zero you have minimum noise, and at plus W you have maximum noise. Now when this happens, your receiver will not be able to reliably demodulate the signal, because at the desired frequency points, minus W to plus W, my power spectral density is less, right? So it will not be able to reliably demodulate or recover the message signal. So to overcome this, what is the solution? So let us see what is the solution to overcome this problem. The solution to overcome this problem is this. So I've already told you that at the transmitter, my power spectral density of M of T will look like this, right? But at the receiver, how does it look like? It looks like this. This is how it is looking like at the receiver, right? This is how it is looking like. Now to transform this into this format, what can we do? Can someone suggest any solution? What do you think is the best possible way? This is what we have received at the receiver. and we want to transform this into a waveform like this. What can we do? Anyone? So if you have any answers, you can unmute yourself and tell me, or you can comment in the chat box. So one possible solution, what I'll do is, I see that by the time the signal reaches the receiver, because of the presence of noise, there is loss in the signal strength. So to compensate, and this loss is inevitable, there will be losses. So to compensate for the losses, what can I do here? To give you a small example, assume that I've transmitted, just example, 10 volts. I've transmitted 10 volts, and here I have received, say, 2 volts. Here I've received 2 volts, right? I've transmitted 10 volts because of the presence of noise. I've received 2 volts, but if I want to receive 5 volts, if I want to receive 5 volts at the receiver, what should I do here? What should be the value that I should be transmitting here? Should I increase the value that I'm going to transmit at the transmitter, or should I decrease the value that I'm going to transmit here? Answer me, please comment in the chat box. I've transmitted, in the first case, I've transmitted 10 volts, and because of noise, I've received 2 volts, but I my desire is to get 5 volts. If I want to get 5 volts, what should be the value sent? Tell me whether I should increase the value transmitted, or should I decrease the value transmitted? Give me the answer. Say yes or no. Should I increase the value or should I not? Should I take names and ask you to give me the answer? In the first place, I've transmitted 10 volts and I've received 2 volts. The loss is because of the presence of noise. My intention is to receive 5 volts here. If I want to receive 5 volts, what should I do to the transmitted signal value? Should I increase or decrease? Very simple question. Thank you. Muhammad Umar Punyesha's answer. So obviously I have to increase this value, and maybe I can make it as, say, 20. By doing this, even though there is loss in the communication channel because of the presence of noises, by the time it reaches the receiver, it may have 5 volts, right? So this is what we are going to do. So here what we will be doing is, we are going to shift this spectrum slightly above like this. So we are going to increase this spectrum above like this, right? So here we will be increasing the signal strength before transmission, and to a significant extent, and at the transmitter we have to do reverse operation, right? At the transmitter I've increased the signal strength before transmission or before modulation, and at the receiver, what should I do? I have to perform the reverse operation, because this amplitude would be increased to a significant level. Thus, at the receiver, I have to do reverse operation. So this process of increasing the amplitude at the transmitter before modulation is referred to as pre-emphasis, or the circuit which performs this operation is called pre-emphasis circuit. And at the receiver, we will perform the reverse operation to decrease this excess amplitude, which is referred to as de-emphasis. Is this clear? Pre-emphasis and de-emphasis. Pre-emphasis is at the transmitter end, and de-emphasis is carried out at the receiver end. Okay. So as I've told you, this is the power spectral density of noise at FM receiver output. You can see at minus W, I have more noise power, right? So by the time it reaches zero frequency, it has decreased, and again at plus W, it has increased. This is exactly reverse to the power spectral density of the message signal. This is the power spectral density of the message signal. Look at minus W, it has become zero, almost zero. And at zero frequency, it is high. And at plus W frequency, again, it is low, right? Ideally, how should this look like? This should look like this, ideally. Ideally, this is how it should look like, ideally. And then ideally, this noise should be a small value like this. Flat line, almost zero, right? But practically, this is what we have got. To overcome this problem, we go for pre-emphasis and de-emphasis circuits. Okay. So the power spectral density of the message signal, typically if it is an audio or video signal, will look like this at the receiver. So that is, the power spectral density of the message falls off appreciably at higher frequencies. These frequencies, the power spectral density of the noise increases at these frequencies. You can see it has increased. And at plus W and minus W, the spectral density of the message, this is the spectral density of the message, is low. You can see at minus W, it is low, and it, at plus W also, it is low. But at plus W and minus W, the noise output is quite high as compared to the message power spectral density, right? So you can see here, okay? So this problem should be handled because the message signal is not utilizing the available bandwidth effectively. We know that FM has larger bandwidth as compared to AM, but this is not utilizing it efficiently. Even though we have given large frequency space for this, at these frequencies, it has decreased, the power has decreased at these frequency points, right? So this problem should be addressed. So what do? We use a pre-emphasis circuit at the transmitter and a de-emphasis circuit at the receiver, right? So this is the pre-emphasis filter before performing the FM transmission. Then at the communication channel, noises will get added up, and FM receiver will demodulate it, and then we will perform de-emphasis, and then we will get the message signal, which will have some noise components. Now here, pre-emphasis and de-emphasis performs same operation, but de-emphasis performs the reverse operation as that of pre-emphasis. For example, if pre-emphasis performs X operation, de-emphasis will perform 1 by X to invert back the excess amplitude injected in the system, right? So if pre-emphasis is adding a factor of X, de-emphasis will remove that factor by dividing by X, right? So that's about pre-emphasis and de-emphasis. Now let us look at the impact of the wave, the power spectral density, due to the presence of pre-emphasis and de-emphasis. So pre-emphasis and de-emphasis are mainly used to increase the reliability or fidelity of the FM transmission, particularly of the audio signals. And you can see this is the power spectral density of the audio signal at minus W and plus W. You can, for noise, you can see at minus plus W and minus W, the power levels have gone up, right? Ideally, this should look like this, right? This is the power spectral density of the message signal, and ideally noise power spectral density should look like this, almost zero value, right? So this is how it looks like, but practically this is how it should look like ideally, but practically this is how it is, right? So at the transmitter, we use pre-emphasis. That is, it is the process of artificially boosting the signal strength, okay, to increase the signal to noise ratio, and it is done at the transmitter before performing frequency modulation. So you can see here, we have boosted the, this is the input to the pre-emphasis, and this is the output of the pre-emphasis. So if you compare this and this signal, you can see we have added up the amplitude here, right? So by using this pre-emphasis circuit, right? So this is the transfer function of this pre-emphasis circuit given by HPE of F, right? So basically adding the or boosting the amplitude to your message signal, right? So this is the pre-emphasis circuit. Now, what will be the process involved in the de-emphasis? The de-emphasis performs the opposite operation, that is, it decreases the signal strength of the message signal to get back the original transmitted signal. So here, this is what will come to the de-emphasis circuit. Here, this de-emphasis circuit will bring this down like this by using de-emphasis filter, right? So this pre-emphasis filter will boost, this will boost the amplitude, right, to increase the signal to noise ratio, whereas the de-emphasis circuit will decrease this to get back our original signal to noise ratio, right? So that's about pre-emphasis and de-emphasis circuits. Okay, and generally a pre-emphasis circuit is kept before the FM modulator, and a de-emphasis circuit is kept after the FM demodulator, right? And this is the, and if you look at FM, the bandwidth of FM is large as compared to AM, and here delta F is the frequency deviation and W is the message signal frequency. Generally, the frequency deviation value or the standard frequency or the maximum deviation that we take is 75 kilohertz, and the associated message signal frequency is 25 kilohertz. By performing pre-emphasis and de-emphasis, we are ensuring that the losses incurred in the power signal, power of, present in the message, or the power of the message signal can be compensated by increasing the power before being transmitted at the transmitter, right? So that is done by using pre-emphasis, which adds artificial or which boosts the amplitude artificially, and de-emphasis will remove that excess amplitude to get back our original SNR value. Okay, so this is the circuit. Pre-emphasis filter, which is used before FM transmitter, then in the communication channel noises will get added up, then it is given to FM receiver, and output of FM receiver is given to de-emphasis circuit to remove excess amplitude. So this PE of F has a transfer function associated with the pre-emphasis filter, and a HDE of F is the transfer function associated with de-emphasis, and as I've already told you, they are inverse, they perform inverse operation, that is HDE of F is equal to 1 by HPE of F. For example, if this is introducing a factor of X, this will remove that factor by 1 by X. So HD of F is equal to 1 over HP of F for frequency range minus W to plus W, right? So thus, if you look at the per spectral density of the noise at the output of the discriminator, this is the equation that we had got without pre-emphasis and de-emphasis circuits. Now, with the presence of pre-emphasis circuit, this component will be modified into this form, that is, we will have integral minus W to plus W F square into mod of HDE of F square into DF. Because of the presence of de-emphasis filter, we will have slight modification in the average output power, right? Because of the presence of de-emphasis filter, right? And here we consider a metric called improvement factor, which is the ratio of average output power without pre-emphasis and de-emphasis, which is what we have discussed in the earlier classes, divided by the average output power with pre-emphasis and de-emphasis circuit, right? And after substitution of the average output power with and without the pre-emphasis and de-emphasis circuits, this is the improvement factor we are going to get. And most importantly, before we focus on improvement factor by using de-emphasis and pre-emphasis circuits. We should ensure that the carrier to noise ratio is above the threshold limit. If you could recall, yesterday I have discussed about the FM threshold reduction method, wherein we have discussed how to increase the SNR at the input of the receiver, also referred to as CNR. This should be above certain threshold. Only then this improvement factor or these pre-emphasis and de-emphasis circuits will be effective. If the received carrier to noise ratio at the input of the bandpass filter is below threshold, these circuits also will not perform reliably, and our FM receiver does not produce a reliable output, will not be able to reliably demodulate the transmitted signal. Therefore, first, as we discussed in the hierarchy, first we should focus on extending the FM threshold limit by increasing its CNR by using mixer and voltage controlled oscillator in the feedback loop. After we ensure that the carrier to noise ratio is above certain threshold, then we can shift our focus to pre-emphasis and de-emphasis circuits, which help us in recovering back the losses that we will incur at the input of the receiver, particularly the power message signal power loss can be overcome by using pre-emphasis and de-emphasis circuits. Okay, so any doubt in these concepts that I've discussed today or in the previous classes? So this point you should keep in mind, that is, this is the noise power spectral density. Ideally, this should look like this. It should be a very small value, ideally, at W minus W and zero. Ideally, this is how it should look like. And if I talk about the power spectral density of the typical message signal, ideally, it should look like this, right? W minus W and zero. But because of the presence of noise at minus W and plus W, we will have more power with respect to noise signal and less power with respect to the message signal. To overcome this, we use pre-emphasis and de-emphasis. At pre-emphasis, what we are doing is we are artificially boosting the amplitude here, so that even if there is loss in the communication channel because of the presence of noises, we do not miss out the message signal. There is no problem in demodulating the message signal, and this de-emphasis circuit will perform the reverse operation, that is, it decreases the excess signal strength, and we will get back our original transmitted message signal. Okay, so pre-emphasis is used before FM transmitter, and de-emphasis is used after FM receiver, right? And these two are inverse to each other. That means if pre-emphasis is adding a factor of x, de-emphasis will add a factor of 1 by x to nullify the effect of pre-emphasis, right, at the last stage. Okay, and we will have improvement in our receiver's performance. But before we apply these circuits, we should ensure that, that is, before we apply pre-emphasis and de-emphasis circuits, we should ensure that the carrier to noise ratio is above certain threshold. Only then we can apply these circuits to get improvement in the received signal to noise ratio or improvement in the reliability factor of the FM receiver's performance. Okay, any doubt here? Any doubt in FM reduction, threshold reduction method, or in pre-emphasis and de-emphasis methods? Okay, so if there are no doubts, let me take attendance.